How do you tell Power BI, go into this Excel file and grab all the sheets, whatever you find, without having to name the sheets one by one? It's like when we say, get data from folder, and it gets all the files. But now we want to go to this Excel file and get all the sheets. But there's no built-in option for this yet. Now, maybe you've already hit this problem, or if you work with Excel files, you're going to hit it soon. And when you do, you'll want to know the right way to solve it. Dynamic, flexible, with no hard coding of the sheet names. Let me show you. I'm Avi Singh, a Power BI Microsoft MVP, and through my online program on learnpowerbi.com, I've helped thousands of business users master Power BI and build beautiful reports. All right, my friends, so let's attempt to solve this. And here is your file. It has multiple tabs or sheets within the same Excel file. And we're going to jump into Power BI and attempt to solve it. By the way, you can get all our files on the link shown here, learnpowerbi.com/download. We're going to jump into the kitchen of our Power BI, transform data, hit that button, and now we're in the kitchen, and we're going to say new source Excel workbook. I'm going to point to that file, Excel multiple sheets. And here, you can just select anything here. Truly, it doesn't matter what you select. Just check the box and hit OK. Now, you know, make sure you're in the query editor. If you were in Excel, remember to hit transform data. Do not say load file because you want to go in the query editor. Now, it does this thing. So first thing we're going to do, now you know that I'm not a fan of the change type step at all. So I always delete that step. So I'm going to delete that step. And then this navigation step, we're also going to delete this one because we don't want a specific sheet. We want to try to get all of them. So now we're back at the source step, which is showing us all the sheets. So I'm going to first rename this query because it's not going to be just one sheet. It's going to be all sheets. And of course, you're going to name it based on the data you're pulling in. If it's sales data you're pulling in, you'll probably want to call it sales. Now that we're here, you may see different kinds of objects there based on what kind of Excel files there are. You will always see sheet, but you may see tables and defined names as well. In this case, we're going to focus on the sheets. So I'm going to use the kind column to select only the sheet type and hit OK. Now that's filtered. And some cases you might have additional filters. Some cases you might be, I only want to pull in sheets which have 2025 at the beginning. Or even better, you could say have four numbers at the beginning. So it's numeric. Obviously, a lot of that is possible in Power BI. We're going to keep it simple. We're going to pull in all sheets in this case. So really, we only need the data column. You may want to keep the name column as well. But for now, we'll just do the data column and we'll say remove other columns. They're gone. And now you're going to hit the magic button, which is these two arrows. Now that's depicts to expand the data. So you're going to click that. It lists us the columns. This is okay. Generally, I uncheck this box, use original column name as prefix, keeps the names compact. And I'm going to hit OK. And bada bing, bada boom, we have our data. Let's do some steps. So we're going to say use first row as headers, bumps it up. Now, what this does, though, is that it has combined all files. So there might be other header rows coming in from other files. So if you click on this in this case and the product key column, and I'm going to hit load more. So you notice I'm having this error here. That's because, yes, that's why I delete this change type step. You should be specifying this at the end, and we'll talk about that in a second. All right, so I've deleted that step. Now let's come back here, and I'm going to hit load more, and you're going to see this product key thing at the top. Now, you don't have to. You can also select like a specific filter, and you can say, hey, this does not equal product key. But I'm just going to come in here and I'm going to uncheck the product key because that indicates the header. There are always a few different ways to do it. You could have actually converted it to a number and then told Power BI to remove errors. It would also have removed those rows, but that's assuming your data is clean and there were not any other errors. I think this is a safe enough way to do it the way we did it right here. So that one is all set. And now all we have to do is just hit close and apply, and it'll load all the sheets from our source data into Power BI. For more tips and tricks, make sure to follow me on LinkedIn and YouTube. And if you're looking for a structured Power BI training program, check out my website, learnpowerbi.com. I'll see you in the next one. Take care and power on.